I'm Dr. Karen Hildebrand with AWS.
And I'm Biagio DeSimone with Aqua Security. And this is my architecture.
Can you tell me about Aqua Security?
Absolutely. So Aqua Security has a CNAPP solution. CNAPP stands for Cloud Native Application Protection Platform. Now, basically what that means is that we want to take cloud native applications and protect them through their entire lifecycle. So that includes the code that they come from, that includes the infrastructure they run on, and that includes the workload itself once deployed. We want to make sure that it's secure through its entire lifecycle.
So Aqua is built on AWS, but you're also providing a solution for customers of AWS. Can you tell us what are the customer use cases that are coming in your direction? What are those customers trying to solve for?
Absolutely. So as customers, you know, move to AWS, really what we are trying to help them do is not only one, understand what they actually need to secure for, right? Because a lot of them don't necessarily know if they're coming from legacy environments, what to secure now in AWS. Also, you know, many of them will have compliance requirements, et cetera. So they might need to make sure things are locked down. They understand networking, behaviors, processes, et cetera, everything running in that environment. So we're helping them understand this in the new kind of cloud native way.
Terrific. Well, let's dive into your architecture.
Absolutely. So what we're looking at here is both Aqua's SaaS solution and over here on the right, a customer environment. So what we are seeing is Aqua's SaaS solution will connect into the AWS environment of the customer. It will then move into what we have here, which is an EKS cluster, so Elastic Kubernetes Service. So we have the customer's applications deployed here on EKS nodes, and you'll also see we have Aqua deployed here on each of the nodes. Now, Aqua is deployed as a daemon set, which means that we are automatically, our agent, right, is scaled across all of the EKS nodes in that cluster. So you always have Aqua sitting next to any of your applications here. Now, what Aqua can do is, because we are so close to the workload and application, we can see all these different behaviors, right? Whether those are kernel level behaviors, whether it's networking, whether it's processes occurring inside the application, we can see all of those. That gives us tremendous visibility and also the option to choose to block those if we, you know, see fit. It's a really great approach that allows you to have really low latency, have a response right away, and have it really native to the environment it's in. We support all sorts of AWS environments like Fargate, Lambda, EKS, ECS, EC2. So we support all the different kinds of cloud native workloads.
Fantastic. So in a containerized workload, for example, what would be some of the trade-offs that a customer might be considering? Is there different ways of approaching this problem?
Absolutely, and Aqua even offers a couple ways. So there is the option for an agentless approach, which would remove the agent that we are seeing here, right, and would basically just be a cloud-to-cloud interaction, right? So that would basically allow Aqua to still see that you have workloads in AWS. We're still able to scan those and assess them, but it doesn't give us the ability to then block, right? Blocking for a lot of customers is the kind of thing that they come for, right? Lots of tools can scan. Aqua is the one that can actually help you go ahead and block, which gives you the prevention that you might need from bad actors, et cetera, in your environments.
Yeah, understanding that surface risk that you have as well as the attack vectors is really important, and then being able to react to them, especially I would imagine in specific industries. Can you tell me, are there specific industry motions that Aqua Security most often sees? Are there industries that are coming to you most often?
Absolutely. So anyone who has applications that need to have really high reliability or are working with sensitive data, right? So someone like financial verticals, right? They're going to have really, really strict requirements as to where their data can live, what it can do, who can access it, et cetera. And they need to be able to, one, stop people from getting there if they're not allowed to, and also be able to report on that, right? They have complex reporting requirements. And so Aqua can not only help them put that blocking in place to ensure that only they have access to what's there, and then if there's anything, you know, not really allowed going on, that we can stop it, but also have that reporting timeline for them so they can understand what happens and when.
So if you're able to do that blocking, what happens to the container during that time?
So the container itself actually stays up. That's one of the really great things about Aqua, is that we're able to block the process or the behavior that's occurring, but allow the application to continue on its own to make sure that only the allowed processes and allowed expected behaviors are occurring. So it really helps you keep that business continuity for those customers that need it.
So from a customer's point of view, the benefit is really that they have their container available, their application that's running is up, and so they don't have that impact to their end customer.
Exactly.
Fantastic. Thank you for bringing your architecture here today and sharing it with us.
It was my pleasure. Thank you.